good as in class. In our homes, most of the time than not, we help our parents in their household chores, and we also run errands for them. Equally, our parents also provide for us all our needs. So in a similar way, how would you describe what we do for our parents and what our parents do for us? In a similar way, how are you going to describe it? Yes? Yeah.
Responsibilities.
So the children always perform their responsibility towards their parents by running around for them, and then the parents also provide for the needs for the children. That's that. So today our topic is going to be rights and responsibilities of the individual. So we are going to look at rights and responsibilities of an individual. Now, every topic on your syllabus or that we are asked to teach you has a particular problem that it is trying to solve, or it's trying to fill a gap. And the problem is that every individual in Ghana has some fundamental human rights. And these rights also pose responsibilities. However, in Ghana, many people are strongly claiming too much of their rights, but fail to perform the corresponding responsibilities. There are others who also are totally ignorant of both their rights and their responsibilities. And this poses a problem to the individual personal achievement and the effort of the country to develop. Are you okay? And for that reason, that rights and responsibilities of the individual is part of your lesson, your topics to be taught at the final meeting. Are you okay? So now, what are rights? When you say rights, what do you mean by rights? What are rights? Yes.
Rights are benefits or privileges that an individual enjoys under the constitution of the state.
Okay, clap us for him. That's a very good attempt. Any other idea? Who is having any different ideas? Provisions necessary for the realization of human dignity. What we mean here is that rights are what we provide for ourselves in order to enhance our human dignity, in order to maintain our human dignity. Are you okay? Or you can also define it to mean that rights are privileges conferred by law and nature on an individual because of the individual membership in an organization or in a community. Are you okay? Rights are privileges conferred by law and nature on an individual because of his or her membership in the community or organization. Are you okay? Now, for instance, As a student in Islamic Senior High School, because of your membership in Islamic Senior High School, you are supposed to enjoy certain privileges, certain rights. What are some of these privileges that you are expected to enjoy as a student? Yes. Is anyone having an idea? Some of the right, your rights as a student of Islamic, yes?
You have the right to life.
The right to life. In Islamic, yes, you right have the right to life or to the right to be protected by the school authorities. Are you okay?
Yes.
You have the right to be protected by the school. But as you are here, we are now your parents. And therefore, any external aggression that is coming towards you, the school authority is supposed to prevent that. Apart from that, it's also your right to be fed 3 times in the school. So you have the right to the school than all. Are you okay? That's your right. Can any person from Busa walk into the school to go to the dining hall to eat? They cannot. Because they are not members of the community Islamic Senior High School. Are you okay? So that's what rights are. Now, then responsibilities. What are responsibilities? Yes.
The obligations that an individual has to perform as a youth.
There are obligations that an individual has to perform as a youth. Any other idea? Let's shine for help so that. Yes, let's shine. Slowly, slowly, quickly, 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 fire. So, what she's saying is that responsibilities are what we are obliged to perform as a duty. What we are mandated to do as a duty is what we call responsibilities. Are you okay? For example, as a student, what are your responsibilities in a school? When you are leaving campus, it's your responsibility to sign an exit. Are you supposed to do that? That's your responsibility. Not only that, when you borrow school materials or library books, you are supposed to return them when they are due. That is your responsibility as a student. Are you okay? Failure to do so, the school rules and regulations will come after you. I hope you are clear. So now, we have forms of rights. Are you okay? The rights are categorized into two. That is, we have civil rights, then we also have natural rights. When they say civil rights are rights that are conferred or that are stipulated in the Constitution. When your rights are stipulated in the Constitution, it is known as civil rights. Are you okay? However, when your rights is endowed on you by God or by nature, it is known as natural rights. Are we for you? So these are the two forms of rights that we have. Then we also have types of rights. We have types of rights. Who can mention any type of right you are familiar with? Yes?
Political rights.
We have political rights. Very good. Well, my friend. Political right. Any other? Yes?
Fundamental rights.
Fundamental human rights. Very good. Also call it natural rights. Are you okay? So the fundamental rights or natural rights. Are you okay? Then the third one is what? Yes?
Economic rights.
Economic rights.
Very good.
Economic rights. Then the fourth one. Yes?
Legal rights.
We have legal rights. Then the fifth one will be yes?
Social rights.
Social rights. Social. Then the last one will be what? Yes, Mary.
Civic rights.
Civic rights. Okay, so we have six different types of rights. So let me explain them briefly what they mean. Okay. Then we now delve into what is our interest. Political rights. Political rights simply means that it's a type of rights that enable an individual to take part in the political activities of the country. Are you okay?
Yes.
So when it comes to voting, when it comes to election, it's the political rights that enable you to do so. Then we have the fundamental human rights. The fundamental human rights, it refers to a type of rights that is inalienable, that cannot be taken away or deprived of an individual without justifiable reason. Are you okay? When they say it's inalienable, what does that mean? Inalienable is from the word alien. That means that it is a type of right that is part and parcel of the individual. It means the individual was born with such rights. Are you okay? That's what we call the fundamental human rights. It's part and parcel of the individual. When you take those rights from the person, it means you are reducing the individual to nothing. Are you okay? And that's what we call fundamental human rights. Then now we also have economic rights. Economic rights also means that it's a type of rights that enables the individual to engage in any legal economic activities of his or her choice to earn a living. Any right that enables the individual to take part or to engage in any lawful economic activities of his or her choice is what we call a what? An economic right. Apart from this, economic right is a type of right that enables the individual to look for a job, okay, and to work under safe conditions. It's your right to look for a job. When you finish school, it's your right to look for a job. Are you okay? And when you get a job, it's also your right to work under safe conditions. Your work should not pose a danger to your life. Are you okay? So that's what we call economic right. Are you okay? Then we have the next one, which is the legal right. The legal right is a type of right that is established and defined by law. A type of right that establishes and it is also defined by what? Law. When you say legal right, it also means that it's a type of right which enables the individual to seek for justice in the court if his or her rights are being trampled upon. Are you okay? If someone tramples upon your right or infringes upon your right, it is your legal right to seek justice in court so that the person will not cope. That's what we call legal rights. Are you okay? Then we also have social rights. Social rights here is a type of right that enables the individual to enjoy the facilities that are provided by the state. Are you okay? Like, for example, the facilities, this school is built by the state. It's your right to enjoy or to use the school. Are you okay? If the state constructs a recreational center, like a community center, entertainment center, it's your right to use it. It's your social right to use it. Are you okay? If the state provides hospital, it's your social right to use the hospital. I hope you are getting it. Then we have civic rights. Civic rights are are also rights which enable the individual, or they are type of rights that are which enable only citizens of a particular country to enjoy them. Are you okay? Civic rights, they are rights that are only enjoyed by people who are citizens of a particular country. Any other person is not allowed to enjoy such a right. Are you okay? For example, only Ghanaians can acquire the Ghanaian passport. If you are a non-Ghanaian, you are not supposed to own or to acquire the Ghanaian passport. So that's your civic right. So like you are saying here, if you want the Ghanaian passport, you only need to apply. Are you okay? And you will be given a Ghanaian passport. But the Togolese or a Nigerian cannot apply for Ghanaian passport. Apart from that, this is your civic right to also register for the voter ID card. And to vote. Are you okay? A non-Ghanaian cannot possess the voter ID card and cannot also vote in our elections. I hope you are getting it. So civic rights are rights that are only enjoyed by people who are citizens of a particular country. I hope you are getting it. So let's now look at the provisions of the Constitution relating to fundamental human rights. So out of the six types of rights that we have talked about, our main interest is on the fundamental human rights. Are you okay? That's our main interest. So what are the provisions of the 1982 Constitution relating to the fundamental human rights? Like I said, fundamental human rights are the inalienable rights that cannot be deprived of an individual without justifiable reason. And they are also known as what? Natural rights, because the individual is born with such rights, and therefore such rights are very difficult to take away from the individual. Are you okay? And so we'll mention some of the fundamental human rights. So provisions of the 1982 Constitution relating to the fundamental human rights of individuals. Are you okay? So first, let's mention some of the fundamental human rights. Then we use the Constitution to see whether we can find them inside the Constitution. Are you okay? So let me mention some of them. What do you want fundamental human rights?
Right to life.
The right to life. Very good. Yes, the right to human dignity. Any other? Yes.
Right to protect public property.
The right to
protect public property.
Yes, it's one of the. It's not a right, but a responsibility. Are you okay?
Yes.
The right to protect public responsibility is not a right. It's your responsibility to protect public property. Are you okay?
Yes.
Yes.
Right.
The right to own property.
Right to
Yes.
Right to personal liberty.
The right to personal liberty. Very good. Any other? Yes.
The right to freedom of movement.
The right to freedom, or just a freedom of movement. Are you okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The rest are many. Are you okay? There are about 9 fundamental human rights. Let me mention the rest. Are you okay? So that we'll move back. So we have the right to life, the right to human dignity, the right to own the property, the right to privacy, the right to personal liberty, freedom of movement. We also have the right to freedom of thoughts, conscience, and religion. Are you okay? We also have the freedom of association and assembly. Are you okay? We also have freedom of speech and what? Expression. So these are the three that we have in making what? 9. So everybody has 9 fundamental human rights. Everybody has a right to number up to the man that can be taken away from the individual without justifiable reason. Are you okay? So let me explain them briefly. Then when I say the right to life, this provides that no one has the right to take the life of another. Are you okay? Then the right to human dignity. This provides that everybody has the right to self-respect and nobody should mar the reputation of the other. Are you okay? You should not lower the standing of a person in society. Are you okay? You should not try to disgrace someone because the person has the right to self-respect. I hope you are getting it. They also have the right to own a property. This provides that everyone or anyone, any individual has the right to acquire legal property of his or her choice, and nobody should restrict him or take that property away from the person without justification. Are you okay? Then you also have the right to privacy. This one also provides that no person, no other person has the right to interfere in the right of another person. This provides that no one has the right to interfere in the private affairs of another. So if you are in your house doing anything, I cannot come to your house to poke my nose on your family matters. Are you okay? Then you have the right to your privacy, and I must respect that. Are you okay? Then you also have another right, the right to personal liberty. This also provides that no one should be imprisoned or arrested without a justifiable reason. So as an individual, no one has the right to lock you inside a room. Are you okay? Without justifiable. If you are being arrested by police, even when they are to arrest you, they are supposed to communicate to you in a language that you understand why you are being arrested. Are you okay? So no matter if you have committed any crime, no one has the right to lock you up. And therefore, your parents have no right to lock you inside a room. Are you okay? It's against your fundamental human right to personal liberty. Then, you also freedom of movement. This also provides that everyone has the right to move to any part of the country without restriction. Are you okay? You can move to any part of the country without anybody restricting your movement. I hope you are getting it. Then, as I mentioned, we also have the right to freedom of thought, conscience, and religion. This means that this provides that everyone has the right to think the way you want to think. Are you okay?
Yes, sir.
And to profess the religion you wish to profess. Then you have the right to choose any religion of your choice. If your parents are Muslims and you want to be a Christian, your parents cannot force you to accept their religion. If your parents are Christians and you want to be a Muslim, your parents cannot stop you from choosing their religion of your choice. Are you okay? You have the right to proffer any religion of your choice. Are you okay? And to think the way you want to think. Then, as I also mentioned, you also have the freedom of speech and expression. You have the right to say and to publish anything you wish to publish, so long as what you say and what you publish is legal. Are you okay? Yeah. You have the right to say anything you want to say. However, what you say should not harm the other person, or should not lower the standard of someone in society. You should not insult someone and say you have the freedom of speech. Are you okay? Or you should not publish, write something, derogate our standard and publish it and say you have the right, you have the freedom of expression. Are you okay? That freedom will be taken, will be arrested. Are you okay? So these are some of the rights that fundamental human rights that we have. So bring out your constitution books and let me present. Yes.
Question.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What is the difference between rights and freedom?
Rights and freedoms.
Yes.
They are more or less the same. They are more or less like synonymous. Are you okay? They are more or less the same. But rights are those things that you are supposed to enjoy. Are you okay? But freedoms can also mean that it is your right to do whatever thing you feel like doing. Are you okay? So freedoms and rights are just like very famous. Are you okay? But sometimes there can be some differences. I hope you're listening. Because on rights, we know we're talking about freedoms. Are you okay? So that's it. Any other question? If you have any question, then you can mention it, you can ask before we progress. Any question? So let's look at our constitution. Look at chapter 5 of the constitution. Go to chapter 5. Specifically to Article 12. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You are all there?
Yes.
Okay. So, one to exemplify what we are passing, the fundamental human rights that we are talking about, to see how the Constitution has given meaning to it. Are you okay? So, you have Article 1, Clause 1. Who talk about the fundamental human rights, and it says, the fundamental human right and freedom enshrined in this chapter shall be respected and upheld by the executive, legislature, and the judiciary, and all other organs of government and its agencies, and where applicable to them, by all natural and legal persons in Ghana, and shall be enforceable by the court as provided for in this constitution. Are you okay? It means all the organs of the state. You have the legislature, you have the executive, and you have the judiciary. They are all expected to respect this fundamental human rights. And what are these rights? So we'll go to Article 13. Are you okay?
Yes.
The right to life. So Article 13, Clause 1 says, no person shall be deprived of his life intentional, except in the exercise of the execution of a sentence of the court in respect of a criminal offense under the laws of Ghana of which he has been convicted. Are you okay?
Yes.
That's talking about your right to life. Then we also move to Article 14. Article 14, Clause 1, which says, every person shall be entitled to his personal liberty, and no person shall be deprived of his personal liberty except in the following cases and in accordance with procedure permitted by law. I hope you're getting it.
Yes.
Then we move to Article 15, Clause 1. Are you there?
Yes.
Article 15, Clause 1 says, the dignity of all persons shall be inviolable. That's Clause 1. And Clause 2 continues, no person shall, whether or not he is arrested, restricted or detained be subjected to, then you have the sections that follow. Section A, torture and other cruel and other inhuman treatment. Are you okay? So this particular article was also speaking about human dignity, as we have discussed. Are you okay?
Yes.
Then we also have another one, which is Article 18, clause 1. I'm going to because some of this is not found over there. Article 18, clause 1, we talk about what? Privacy and what? And the right to own what? Property. So they box the two together. Are you okay? So Article 18 says, Article 18, clause 1 says what? Every person has the right to own property, either alone or in association with others. Are you okay?
Yes.
And then the clause 2 continues to say that no person shall be subjected to interference with the privacy of his home, property, correspondence, or community, except in accordance with law and as may be necessary in free and democratic society for public safety or the economic well-being of the country, for the protection of health or morals, for the prevention of disorder or crime, or for the protection of the rights or freedom of others. So these are some of the provisions of the Constitution related to fundamental human rights. Are you okay?
Yes.
Any question? If you have a question, you can ask. Yes.
You said everyone has the freedom of movement.
Yes.
But according to the law, there are some people in Ghana here which freedom of movement are restricted.
Yes. Well, there are certain circumstances where your freedom of movement can be restricted. And that will be taught in our next lesson. Are you ready? Like for example, during a state of emergency, when there's a conflict and they declare a particular place as a state of emergency, where they declare curfew, where there's curfew, your freedom of movement will be killed. But you are supposed to go inside from a particular time to another time. Are you ready? So your freedom of movement will be killed. Also, when you are affected by contagious disease, when you have a disease that can be transferred from one person to another, your freedom of movement will be curtailed. Are you okay? Also, when you commit a crime and you are convicted, your freedom of movement will be curtailed. Are you okay? So in our next lesson, we're looking at ways by which the rights of the individual can be curtailed. Are you okay?
Yes.
Any other question? Okay. So without any question, we take down these questions as assignment. Write down these questions as assignment. Very good. Question 1. Define the following terms. Define the following terms. Define the following terms. Rights and responsibilities. Rights and so rights in quotation mark, and then responsibilities also in quotation mark. Are you okay? Rights and responsibilities. We define them. Are you there?
Yes.
Then the next question, question 2. State the provision of the 1982 Constitution of Ghana. State four provisions of the 1982 Constitution of Ghana. State four provisions of the 1982 Constitution of Ghana relating to the fundamental human rights of individuals. Relating to the fundamental human rights of the individual.
Relating to?
To the fundamental human rights of the individual. So I will map them the next time we meet.